Hello, Leo.
Welcome to Intuitive Gems. My name is Desiree, and I will be doing your money, wealth, finance, prosperity, abundance reading for the month of October 2021. If this is your first time catching one of my readings, I do want to say welcome, and I invite you to subscribe because I do these readings each and every month. And I would love to share your money message with you. For the readings this month, I will be using my original tarot deck. I will clarify with my Radiant Rider-Waite tarot, and then I will close out your reading, Leo, with a Halloween oracle card. Yes, it is my favorite time of year. I love fall. It's my birthday time. I love Halloween, all the things, so I'm very excited. I also have two new announcements. A lot of you have been messaging me about starting your own business, which I think is very exciting. And a few of you have asked me, you know, how do I know when it's time to quit and go full time with my business? Well, I have created a checklist, a free checklist. It's available to anybody who wants it, that will tell you the six things you need to have in place before you quit your job to go into your business full time. And you know, I think all of these things are important, but it's something that you just kind of need to be aware of before you kind of make that transition. So I will have that linked in the description for you, for those of you who are interested. And I also have been getting some messages about private readings. If you do not know, I have decided to take a break with private readings until January of 2022. But I am excited to let you know that I have partnered with Keen.com. It is the largest online psychic network, I think, in the world. I have several friends who are psychics on Keen, and I have used them. I have partnered with them. This is going on 3 years now. And they do have a special coupon code, $1.99 for 10 minutes if you are a brand new customer. So if you're interested in that, I will also have that linked in the description for you as well. Okay. So let's go ahead and jump right into the reading for Leo and see what shows up for my beautiful Leos as it relates to money, wealth, finances, prosperity, ooh, nice, and abundance for the month of October 2021. What do we need to know for the sign of Leo? All right, Leo, so October is gonna start off with a bang, really. I mean, for you, Leo, things are definitely gonna be moving and shaking, and you're gonna be attracting a lot of attention. You may feel a little overwhelmed. You may not know what to expect, but I have to tell you, it's going to be all good, right? It's going to be good. Money is going to be moving for you, right? It's coming in, you're investing it out, you're spending it out, you're doing what you got to do. Okay. So the first week of October, I can tell you, is going to be a very busy time for you financially. Now let's go ahead and read through this and see what exactly do we need to be aware of as it relates to our finances as we move into the month of October, 2021. Well, we have the Justice card in the reverse. This means that there's some decisions being made and you have no input. You have no say in the matter. You have no, you know, influence one way or the other, you know, and this is something that does affect your money. Now, it could be something at your job, could be something as it relates to your business, or if you're an investor, if you're in real estate, maybe something as it relates to properties. I don't know. But there's a decision being made here that you have no control over, or you have no input. Now, next we have the Six of Wands. Now, this is where things get good and things get really, really fun, because you're going to be attracting a lot of attention. Now, whether this be public attention, you know, it's going to be good. Doesn't matter. Maybe social media. Maybe you're on the news or in the paper in your town. I don't know. But you're definitely going to be attracting a lot of positive attention, which means that you can attract potential new customers, new clients, maybe even, you know, create a new job or a new business for yourself. Whatever the case may be, it's going to be good. So get comfortable with the spotlight being on you, Leo. Next, we have the Eight of Swords. Now, this is the card of sometimes feeling trapped by your own beliefs or your own emotional blocks or your own, self-limiting things that hold you back. It's like nothing's holding you back, but your thought that something is holding you back is what's holding you back. So go ahead and work through those self-limiting beliefs and really call attention to what needs to be worked on within you, because the inner work, again, sometimes is the only thing that needs to shift in order for you to really have a huge breakthrough, and the money will literally start pouring in. And I'm not exaggerating when I say this, because I've seen this happen in my own life where, you know, I really had to do some inner work. I really had to reprogram my subconscious. It's a process. It doesn't happen overnight. But I tell you that once you release some things that were in the way, money really just unexpectedly shows up. Next, we have the Magician. There's a lot of things available to you, Leo, that you may not be tapping into. You know, you have a lot of resources and you may not be utilizing them all to their fullest capacity. So pay attention to that, because you have the tools, the talent, the connections, the experience, the wisdom, whatever. You have everything you need in order to create an empire if that is your goal. Next, we have the Ace of Pentacles. I love, love, love this card, especially in these readings, because it talks about starting a new business, starting a new job, really making good decisions if you're starting to invest or if you're continuing to invest. It's just all good as it relates to money for you. Now, the Ace of Pentacles is a money card. It's very, very good. It doesn't necessarily have to be money that's tied to a job or money that's tied to a particular person or a relationship. This is just money in general for you, and it's very, very good. Now, because you're not sitting here across from me, I can't tell you specifically where I think this money is going to come from, but I do think that just in general, I'm really picking up that this is money that just kind of shows up, money that was intended for you. So it could be maybe somebody owes you money, maybe you win some money. It's money that is intentionally yours, right? So it could come from a job, but it doesn't necessarily have to. So I don't want you to think that it's only my job money that could come to me. No, 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 no. There's a lot of ways money can come to you. Maybe you sell something and someone says, you know, I love this so much, I'll pay you double than what you're asking. I mean, who the heck knows? But all I can say is that this is really, really good. Finally, we have the Three of Cups in the reverse. I don't like seeing that in the reverse, because it usually means there's a third party meddling where they don't need to meddle. Now, because this isn't a relationship reading, this is not a relationship thing, but there's probably somebody involved in your financial affairs somewhere who doesn't need to be there, right? I don't want to say an unwelcome third party, but it's an unnecessary third party, right? So you need to clean that up, because you don't want too many hands in the in the wallet, whatever the phrase is. But I think you know what I mean, right? If there's somebody, you know, involved and they don't need to be, and it doesn't have to necessarily be money. Now, this could be your business. Go ahead and clean that up, okay? And I'm feeling like this is more of a heads up. It's not necessarily a prediction, but this is just calling something to your awareness that needs to be taken care of. All right, Leo, let's see what else shows up for you as it relates to money, wealth, finances, prosperity, and abundance for the month of October 2021. Okay, so as we move into the second week of October, Leo, you're going to be in a very good position financially. You're going to be in a position to give, which is what I'm seeing here. The other thing, though, is I see you doing a lot of work by yourself. Why? Because some help that was promised doesn't come through. I also see the Ten of Pentacles here. This is a card of independently working. Solopreneurship for some of you. Working by yourself instead of in a group setting. That's what I'm getting with this card here, and I'm also getting that with this here. Knight of Cups in the reverse tells me that you were expecting someone to help and they don't come through, or they fall short of what they had promised. And this isn't necessarily a bad thing. I have a feeling you probably already kind of knew this person was flaky, or you already kind of knew that whatever was supposed to show up probably wasn't going to, or it wasn't going to be good if they did. So, you know, you're going to be doing a lot of work by yourself. But the good thing is that's going to really put you ahead. We've got the Six of Pentacles here. The Six of Pentacles talks about you being in a position to be very, very generous. Now, I like to say that you're going to be very generous with your finances, but that doesn't always mean, you know, you could be very generous with your time, your attention, your knowledge, you know, whatever, your resources. But you're going to be in a position to give. And when you're in a position to give, that means you have overflow. And when you give from overflow, you really serve people in a very beautiful way, in a way that comes through much more authentically than if you're sharing because you're expecting something back. Okay, so that's a very good place to be. We also have the Two of Swords here. This means you've made a decision about something. You're not hemming and hawing. You've made a money decision, either how you're going to invest, how you're going to save, how you're going to make more money, whatever the case may be. You definitely have something working in your favor as far as you making a decision and being able to take action towards making the money or having the money or investing the money. So it's going to be really, really good. Like I said, you're going to be doing a lot of this soul searching on your own as we move into the second week of October. And I think it's going to be something, it's going to be very enlightening for you. Now we do have the Ace of Cups here. The Ace of Cups in the reverse tells me that something doesn't quite hit the target as far as how you were expecting it to. Now, sometimes this shows up in relationships, but because we're talking about money, I have a feeling that your heart was set on something and you thought this could be the thing. And for some reason, this you realize is not the thing, right? Could be a job. Could be something in your business. Could be a potential supplier, vendor, customer, whatever, right? So don't feel bad. Again, because I think this gives you more intuitive knowledge, it gives you more experience about what you can do and what you can't do, right? About what you are not feeling maybe totally 100% confident about. You know, and everything's a learning process, especially when it comes to money. You know, nobody has all the answers and there's always more to learn. So, you know, give yourself grace and don't think you did anything wrong if something doesn't show up or something doesn't unfold in the way that you thought that it would. All right, Leo, let's see what else shows up for you. As it relates to money, wealth, finances. Prosperity and abundance for the month of October 2021. All right, so as we move into the second half of the month, it looks like there's going to be the word recovery is coming through, and it's not recovery physically. I'm talking about recovery of some recovery of something that does have a financial connection. I say that because the Seven of Swords here, now the Seven of Swords is a very shifty card. It's a very shady card. However, when it shows up in the reverse, this means that something gets corrected, something gets recovered. So if something was stolen, it gets recovered and returned to you. If something was broken, it gets repaired and given back to you. It's one of those things where the wrong gets corrected in some way. But the word recovery is coming through very clearly for me. So I'm feeling, Leo, see, because I'm thinking of the word recovery like when they recover stolen goods. So I don't know. That may resonate with some of you. Maybe that's why. Maybe a lot of you. That's why it's coming through. But you know, something gets recovered. Maybe something was lost and it gets found and it gets delivered back to you. Whatever it is, there's definitely a money connection, a financial connection to it, and it's going to be good. Next, we have the King of Swords. Now, the King of Swords is cutting away, but sometimes he's very abrupt and he's very abrasive, and he cuts things away that it's like he overdoes it, right? You know, I dated a guy like that. You know, he had a business, and he just kind of went on a firing spree because one person kind of messed things up, and he said, well, you know, we just need to get rid of everybody. And I said, that's a little bit much, but that's what I'm picking up from this here, right? So you may need to cut something off, but just be sure not to go overboard, right? Don't shoot yourself in the foot, because you don't want to, you know, overdo, overreach, you know. You don't want to overcompensate for something, right? Now, again, as this relates to your money, make sure you're not, you know, doing something that you're going to regret later, I guess would be the easiest, probably most direct way to say it. Next, we have the Page of Wands. This is good news coming through as it relates to your work. We've also got the Knight of Pentacles, which means some type of financial assistance is showing up for you in a very big way. This is all good because it's falling onto the Six of Pentacles, which is the Generosity card. So you have good news as it relates to work. Financial assistance showing up. You're in a position to be generous. I mean, can it get any better? The middle of the month is going to be very, very enlightening for you, Leo. I hope you're ready for it. Next, we have the Queen of Wands, which means that sometimes things could be a little shaky in the workplace. It's more like a heads up, not necessarily a prediction, but if things feel a little off when you go to the office, understand that it's not you. It's probably something energetically within that environment, okay? And do your best to kind of stay neutral to the best of your ability and try not to get too affected by it. Okay, because things will feel a little off. Next, we have the Four of Pentacles in reverse. Now, sometimes this card shows up when we give too much, but I'm feeling like this is the card that's telling me you're giving probably in the wrong place. Pay attention to where you are, you know, sharing, right? Are you giving to the right charity that you want to give to financially? Are you spending time where you're going to get the best return on your investment? Are you making a wise purchase that is going to pay off in the long term? Make sure you're not being frivolous in one area at the expense of another area, okay? All right, Leo, let's see what else shows up for you. As it relates to money, wealth, finances, prosperity and abundance. For the month of October 2021. All right, Leo, as we close out the month of October, things really probably will feel a little disruptive. But here's the thing. When all is said and done, it's going to come together in a very beautiful way. But we've got the Seven of Cups here. The Seven of Cups means you're not going to feel like you have a lot of options as far as what you're going to do, where you're going to go, how you're going to spend, how you're going to invest, how you're going to save. You're going to feel kind of limited, okay? But that doesn't necessarily mean that you are. Maybe you're limited in this particular moment, but it doesn't mean you're limited in general, okay? So the end of the month will probably be a month for you to kind of just stay still. You don't necessarily have to be too proactive, but at the same time, you don't want to, you know, what's the word? Like step back. You don't want to like not do anything. But if you are kind of in a place where you're not quite sure of what your next move should be, it's okay to stay put for a while, okay? It's totally okay to stay put. We also have the Wheel of Fortune in the reverse, which means things really are turning, things are shifting, things are moving. You may not understand it, it may not make sense, you may think that this is a bad thing, but the Wheel of Fortune tells us that things always turn and they're consistently turning. things are constantly in change. Things are constantly in motion. So even though it may feel like this is not working out in your favor, you have to understand that that's only temporary. You have to understand that this does not mean this is the end of your money story. It doesn't mean that you're not going to get what you want. It doesn't mean any of that, right? But you have to understand that sometimes things shift. Sometimes things go through a process, and you have to kind of ride that through in order to make it out on the other side. And you totally will because of what we're seeing here. We have the Five of Swords. This tells me that communication could be a little strained at the end of the month. So if you can, avoid having conversations about money around that time if it's possible. If not, don't sweat it. But, you know, some people just may not be as receptive to your ideas or to your input. And you don't want to get into an argument or a bickering match or any of that, right? You don't want to use your energy in that way. But here's where things get really, really nice. We have the Lover's card. Now, the Lover's card is a very passionate, hot energy card, but it's also a card of coming together, of a divine union. It's also about passion, love, all the beautiful things that really make life worth living in some way. And you will be experiencing that. Now, you may kind of get there in a wonky way, but if you trust the process, you're going to feel really, really good. You're going to feel like this is the right thing right now. My money is okay, or my work or my business is coming together in the way that it's supposed to for me right now, right? Because, you know, sometimes you got to feel really, really good about who you are and what you're doing. And once you kind of embrace that, then everything else gets reflected in that. You know, so I want you to trust the process, and I really want you to trust yourself, Leo. All right. Let's go ahead and close out your reading with a Halloween Oracle card. Ooh. All right. You got the card Scrying. And at the bottom it says Intuition. Yes, it's about trusting yourself. It's about following your own path and having the confidence and the courage to keep going. So Leo, I hope this was helpful. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, observations, please drop them down below. I want to thank you so much for choosing to spend this time with me. We'll do it all again next month.